Finally, we have modern dance. Now, modern dance, just as a reminder, is basically an antithesis, or exists in opposition to ballet. They felt that ballet could not speak to contemporary audiences. So they tried to create something that was different, that was more modern. And instead of wearing pointe shoes or something like that, generally they're barefoot, they're interacting with the floor. And eventually, of course, one of the things they will complain about in terms of ballet is that it's based on these formal, conventionalized, modeled forms, that you have to use these specific poses and these specific movements. And ironically, modern dance will fall into exactly that prescribed model. Obviously, different poses and movements, but the same principle. So where does it come from? Well, modern dance will develop in the 1920s, in large part thanks to Ruth Saint-Denis, D-E-N-I-S, and her husband, Ted Shawn, who will open Denishawn Dance Studios. And Saint-Denis' dance was a mix of the exotic and oriental interpretations. She's looking at these other forms, non-Western forms, dances of India, dances of China, etc. And then she will try and draw those in, or elements of them in, mix them with jazz dance, with ballet, with other European forms to create something very different. And they will create a studio of dance based in Los Angeles, following this very eclectic approach to dance. And she uses all sorts of traditions, from Native American dance to ballet and Oriental, in just about all of her choreography. So by mixing all of these ideas, much like the Romans didn't come up with their architectural ideas and their artistic ideas, they're usually taking elements from other people's and mixing them differently. Denishawn is doing the same thing. They're taking elements of Native American dance, Chinese dance, Indian dance, etc., and mixing them together to create something that will be original. And as before, please go over to D2L and take a look at the video clips that I have linked there to see some examples of Denishawn's dancing. And I should warn you, I believe at least one clip will be a silent film. We are very early in the 1920s before we have sound for film, for motion pictures.